Today on Animal Fact Files, we're discussing feathertail gliders and feathertail possums. There are three living species in this marsupial family, and these species are divided into two separate genera. One species, the feathertail possum, exists in New Guinea, while the other two species, the feathertail gliders, are only known to live in eastern mainland Australia. They get their common name, feathertail, from the unique appearance of their tail. It looks very much like a long tail feather from a predatory bird. The hairs lining the side of this flat tail are stiff, which keeps it rigid while balancing on tree branches or gliding. In this way, it acts like a rudder. Although not fully capable of flight, feathertail gliders do exactly as their name implies. Equipped with a thin flap of skin between their elbows and knees on both sides of their body, these marsupials can soar more than 65 feet, 20 meters between trees. They live in both wet and dry forested areas and have serrated toe pads which give them grip, even on smooth surface trees such as eucalyptus. Feathertail possums, on the other hand, do not have that skin flap and are not able to glide, but they're still experienced trapeze artists in the trees. Trapeze artists, perhaps? The feathertail on all species can hold onto branches, and these tiny mammals are such excellent climbers, they can cling to a smooth, vertical pane of glass. That's a grip to rival geckos. When describing them as small, we truly do mean small. Feathertail gliders are some of the smallest living gliding mammals, averaging less than 6 inches, 15 centimeters, in total length. They're mouse-sized. Feathertail possums are not much bigger, measuring around 10 inches, 25 centimeters long, as adults. These marsupials appear darker across their back with a creamy to white underside. The possum has black stripes that run vertically down across its eyes, while the gliders have darker eye patches. Feathertail gliders and possums are rarely seen, but that doesn't mean they're not around. Much like raccoons, these small mammals are nocturnal, limiting their activity to nighttime. Feathertails are pollinators. They consume nectar and pollen, as well as sap, fruits, blossoms, and even honeydew, which is a sweet liquid produced by insects such as aphids. The feathertails also eat insects and other invertebrates. An arboreal lifestyle helps protect these mammals from predators, but they're still taken by ravens, owls, snakes, monitor lizards, sugar gliders, and ghost bats. What's more, feathertails are threatened by introduced animals such as foxes and domestic cats. That being said, they seem to benefit from agricultural practices that disturb forest habitat, as long as there is enough vegetation for foraging above the forest floor. Feathertails live in small groups of 2 or 3, spending their days resting in tree hollows. They take multiple partners when breeding, and it's not uncommon for a litter to be fathered by different males, or for a female to feed young that she didn't produce. The babies are kept in a pouch that faces the mother's rear end. They'll stay here for just over 2 months before venturing out. They're weaned around 100 days old and are nearly adult-sized by 5 months of age. Although they're small, feathertails can live for more than half a decade in the wild. Much like the Virginia opossum, feathertail litter sizes are limited by their nipples. Feathertail gliders are most frequently observed with 4 nipples, while feathertail possums more commonly have only 2. Besides helping child rearing, another benefit of group living is that feathertails can huddle for warmth. When the temperature reaches 50 degrees Fahrenheit, 10 degrees Celsius, they enter a low energy state which helps them stave off starvation. This state becomes even more effective when they huddle together. There's more to learn over on the AFF Patreon. Our supporters, Dad, SpikeSpiegel93, and everyone else help us bring these videos to you for free. Give a thumbs up if you learned something new today, and thanks for watching Animal Fact Files.